The present, I start to search in economy, Bronze Age economy, after a few discussions with my Eastern colleagues about the late Bronze Age, and they speak about half sedentary people. I don't believe in this kind of economical system because we have in Transylvania six type of grain. We have chickpea, a lot of cereals and so on, and it's impossible to be in migration. In the same time, Transylvania is known like one of the richest part of Europe in copper, gold, and salt. You will see, and I think the non-monetary economy, it was apparently free, but the level it was very strictly controlled by the tribal power or something, because such great production of gold, bronze, and salt, it's a huge value, huge. They must be very, very strictly controlled and protected. It's very interesting that Transylvania, in 1,000 years, we haven't fortification. Because, and I think they was so rich, so powerful, and they can buy the peace, and they, in the same time, have sufficient troops, army, to fight if it's necessary. We have in Transylvania, we found hundreds of swords and another type of weapons. Now, yes. I believe it's very interesting in Transylvania, like in prehistory, it's just working the changing. This old man make a vat for salt or grain water. You can see, use iron tools, but you have the bronze tools for wood. It's the same type of vat we found it in salt mines in Transylvania. They work in the very similar system, like in prehistory. Now, maybe it's crazy. I excavate in a village, Buza, late Bronze Age settlement, and I found three pieces of grains. But what is interesting, it's from three volcanic, different volcanic origin. We have pieces from northeast, from Rota Mountains, from Western Carpathian, Northwestern Carpathian, and Southwestern Carpathians. If we're thinking in Bronze Age, we have in Transylvania around 1,000 settlements. We can imagine how great was the production of the stones, not just the metal and gold and the salt. It's a stupid stone, but it's not stupid. And fortunately, I meet these people, this guy, who make me in 20 minutes from stone a plate from the heaven to put it in the heaven in 20 minutes with the same tools like in prehistory. I think exist local industry for direct change, like the vet, like the greens, to go from the mountains, from not the gold area or copper area, to go in the plain and come back with the grain. And in Transylvania, it's function in a very this day. This photo was made in July in this year. Yes, it's a part of geological treasure from Transylvania. We have 2 points of with tin. The last mine, tin mine in Transylvania was closed in 2002. tin and black. The white is sold. We have a lot of copper and gold. Near Cluj, the biggest salt mine, it's in a salt mountains, have 700 meters deep. I think it's the deepest from Europe. We can start now with the miners. The photos is from Roșia Montană in 32, and this is from early Bronze Age, represent a miner or a god of the miners. We don't know, but sure they have a very serious organization there. Now, it's a little bit modern. It's a Mureș Valley, the biggest river from Transylvania. It's an Austrian plain for the port on the river. We know that on the river they go to sell it the salt. But from the mountain we have the cork, and they come with the serious wood. It's from Somers Valley, from the same regions where when they make the vat. And a few Transylvanian weapons, very probably the APA type, you know it. And all of them have the bolts, all. Have the shape of a boat. It's some tools from the salt mine, and it's very interesting. We have some marks. We don't know what means. And now, because we discuss about trade, the long distance trade, we have evidence of presence of Minoan people in Transylvania, because we have the model of the boats, and we have from Syria, Egypt, Crete, and we have on the Mureș Valley, we have the same. And because that people was very clever, they put wheels on the boat to can take the terrestrial road between two rivers. And from Cluj to Denmark, to the Baltic Sea, Cluj is on a level of 353 meter altitude. To the Baltic Sea, we have just in Slovakia a hill with 500 meters. it's very, very simple to go there. And it's another example. We have Czernowina Cliff. We have more like 10,000 amber and glass pieces and bronze pieces. And the amber comes from Denmark. The pieces come from Mycenae, Egypt and so on, but on Mycenaean road. And very probably there was a point of meeting between southern commercial with the Nordic one. And from this point of view, because Harding tell it for the first time, I think Transylvania was a round table for bronze economy in this period. Thank you. And I have a problem with. Yes, this is a few conclusion, but for my colleagues from Leiden and Romania, it's from Ulumburun. They have balance, and please resolve my problem.